Hi my loves, we're going to do a reading on Anna Nicole's birth chart. It's the best to my ability and where I think the attraction is, because people like say, oh, was she really attracted to Howard Marks and Howard K. Stern and all stuff like that. So we're going to have a look. Here we go. So here's Vicky Lynn's chart. Right, we're going to start the first house. Right, the first house is cusping on the 12th house like it does in Placidus. So you can see that Venus and Libra are in Venus and the Moon are in Libra. Magnetic personality, so she's ultra feminine, yeah, she's ultra, ultra feminine. But then look, we look to her fourth house over here, which is Mars in Aquarius. No, it's in Capricorn, sorry. So she is going to be attracted to older men. And yes, this might be money, because the fourth house rules money. Some people disagree that the dad is the fourth house and the mum's the tenth house. I tend to think it's the mum that's more the fourth house. But look, we've got Mars in there. And Mars, Capricorn, is an older man. And obviously, family. It meant the world to her. I truly believe she loved this man. Anyone else can think that way, one. And then look, we go to the sixth house. Chiron is in the sixth house in Aries. So Aries is like the head and all things like that. Did the guy have a hemorrhage or something? How did he die? I don't know. Because Chiron's there, that's the wounded healer. And Saturn is the planet of like her wisdom, and it's a malefic. Like Venus and Jupiter are the malefic planets, and Saturn and Pluto are malefic planets, and then Venus and Mars. Oh yeah, Mars is a malefic as well. So they're harder, challenging planets. And then Venus is Mercury is in between the two. So, and then you see that her north node is in her seventh house. I've got this position. So that means her position in life is to understand relationships. And in that house, that's the Libra house, but it's in a Taurus, it's in an Aries Libra axis anyway, but the other way around. So she's striving to be more like an Aries, but in the seventh house, so it's a little bit confusing. And then the midheaven sits in Cancer, and they often say the midheaven is your relationship with your fans. The fans adored her. They adored her like they adored Marilyn Monroe. So midheaven is going to make someone feel quite familiar to you in Cancer, because Cancer is a very like cozy, comfortable sign. And then Jupiter is in Virgo, which is a very demonstrative planet for Jupiter to be in, with Pluto and Uranus. That's going to have been hard for her in the 12th house, and that's definitely going to have contributed to her addiction issues. She might have done it in a very obsessive way, where it's in Virgo. She might have been like a bit of a control freak with it. And that is my analysis on that person. If you want any, ask me any person you'd like me to have a look at, and I will try my best. Thank you.